fact, most of the time they even have the same amniotic sac surrounding them. Not always, but usually. So it's relatively easy to determine the difference between a fraternal and an identical twin type of thing.
1956 through 1933, Erwin Mickelberg taught in the biology department at Augsburg College. His main area of teaching was human anatomy and physiology, which he taught to countless thousands of nursing and phy-ed majors, among others. Maybe the best way to understand Professor Mickelberg as a teacher would be to ask his students. After a 39-year tenure, they were surprisingly easy to find. Well, their thoughts and experiences seem to share the same basic theme.
You know, take a class from somebody that's going to entertain you, that's you know, way better than just some dull class where, you know, there's knowing your material and then there's knowing your material and being able to entertain with it. But I think even more than that, I think when people took the class, they found out how simple he made these very complex ideas about biology and how things worked inside of the human body. He really made that a simple thing, just with real basic analogies.
He really took time out to get to know the students and to talk to the students, particularly on lab days. While the students were working on their labs, he'd go around and talk to students. He'd talk to us about our where we're from and our families, or he'd even talk to us about his family.
Yeah, he made it interesting. He made booklets of our workbook that was put in a lot of information, but he had it so that you could color it in or kind of fill in the blanks, and so you kind of made it your own workbook and helped you remember all the bones and everything. He had us do flashcards for ourselves and things like that. Just, he was a very good teacher. I mean, of all the teachers I remember, I do remember him, and I enjoyed his class.
But students weren't the only ones who can say what effects he had in his work. Though the students he touched in multitude, the faculty at Augsburg knew Erwin better than most. I had a chance to get many former biology teachers, student assistants, and friends together to talk about the old times and the memories they carry with them. Over laughs and jokes, they all remembered different things about Irv. Some knew him as a storyteller over a cup of coffee in the teacher's lounge.
Irv told me at coffee one day that we were talking about home, and he was talking about how he and his father would leave La Crosse and go to Galesville and pick up his old Norwegian guide and go duck hunting on the Black River by Hunter's Bridge,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Right next to the a little saloon I used to hang out at with when I was a kid. Anyway, they get down in the duck blind, and they're downriver, and upriver are a bunch of Chicago tenderfeet with their shotguns, their expensive stuff, and the guy says, well, we'll just sit here till the ducks come. And the ducks come flying downriver, and before they even get in range, the Chicago, boom, bang, boom, and the ducks turn around and fly back all day long. They do this. They're just soggy with cold and awful. I mean, anyone who go duck hunting deserves something like this. But and finally, the Norwegian guy gets more and more impatient with these Chicago tenderfeet because they're always shooting out of range, and these guys never get a shot. And finally, right before hunting the hours close, the Norwegian hollers up the river to the Chicago. What do you think you got up there? An anti-craft air gun?
Yeah. Well, he added a cuss word in there too. What the hell do you think you got up there? An anti-craft air gun?
I cleaned it up a little bit.
Others knew him as an artist.
And good with chalk. You were good with colored chalk. This was before, you know, we had the handsomely illustrated text. So you'd see these drawings on the board, you know, that would allow you to form a picture of all of the words in the text. And he was gifted with that.
He went all through life looking for the blues and the red stripes.
And still others knew him as a dedicated teacher who was loved by students.
I remember all the nursing students that would always be at your door because they had to keep a certain grade point to stay in the nursing program. Quite often you'd hear a nurse inside his office just crying on his shoulder. I always was just glad it wasn't me they were coming to.
Irwin retired in 1993, and in 2006, 13 years later, all of these people were quick to gather on one day to visit and share their memories. And what did they answer when they were asked about Irwin Mickelberg? It wasn't what he taught or even what he said. The memories he created with his personality and his presence are the ones that have lasted.
She had to be free.